Praise the Lord. You know, we've got the offering origins. The Word of God is always wonderful. But today, because of the worship, you know, I don't know if you realize or were thinking about it. I was just lost in the worship because the forgiveness of what I've done in my life, everything, He's forgiven. He made atonement for. We were immersed into His death and we were resurrected to life through Him. He's broken off our chains and our bondages. And because of Him, we live and we have life more abundantly. And as we move into the origin, it even means more. Today's offering origin is great abundance of good things. Great abundance of good things. Not so-so things, not bad things, not maybe things, but good things. Everybody say good. God is good. Amen. Deuteronomy 28, 11 through 14. Whew, sun's out. Praise God. S-O-N. Deuteronomy 28, 14, 11 through 14. The Lord will give you great abundance of good things, of the fruit of your body, the fruit of your livestock, and the fruit of your land, in the land that the Lord swore to your ancestors to give you. The Lord will open for you His good treasure, the sky, to give your land its rain at the right seasons and to bless everything you undertake. You will lend to many nations and not borrow. The Lord will make you the head and not the tail, and you will be only above, never below, if you will listen to, observe, and obey the commands of the Lord your God and not turn away from any of the words that I am ordering you today, neither to the right nor to the left, to follow after other gods and serve them. Amen. Now you may think, well, he was talking about the people of Israel and it was an agrarian society. He was going to bless. You know what? God's word is alive today. It's sharper than any two-edged sword. What it meant then, it means today, and it means tomorrow. It may not be an agrarian society, but all the blessings that he was talking about, we have, and we have already received. Because as he's done Acharit, as Pastor Joe teaches, he's already seen everything that is ever going to happen. And then he went back and he created. So all the good that is going to happen has happened. We just have to live it out. The Lord's promise is to give us a great abundance of good things. He goes on to say that he will bless us with children. Hopefully he's talking to those that are married, right? Amen. He will bless our endeavors. Everything that we put our hands to, he will bless. Even our land will be fruitful. The Lord even promises to give us the land he swore to give to our ancestors. So a promise that was made to your great-grandfather, your grandfather, your father, is going to come to pass for you. He says that he will open his good treasure for us and bless everything we undertake. Say all means all. It's not just some things. He is going to bless everything that we undertake. That means his promise is to bless us. It supersedes any curse that has been spoken against us. You need to understand that and please receive it. His blessings supersede any curse that anybody has spoken over you. Cannot be fulfilled, because if God promises to bless, he will not change his mind. It's in his word. He's going to prosper us to the point that we will lend to the nations and not have to borrow. That's a pretty big thing if you think about it. We are going to be on top of the things that he wants us to succeed at, and not under them. You're in front of the curve instead of behind the curve. That means that we will always be ahead of things and not behind them. The Lord only asks one thing to make this happen. Obedience. Again, if you will listen to, observe, and obey the commands of the Lord, your God, and not turn away from any of the words that I am ordering you today, neither to the right nor to the left, to follow other gods and serve them, then he's going to do all those things that he promised to do for you. I think that God is offering us a pretty good deal. All the blessings if we obey what he wants us to do. Pretty simple. After all he wants us to do is love him and love our brothers and sisters with all the love we are capable of giving. Nothing more, nothing less, and we will get an abundance of good things. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. Now we can show him our love for him, wanting nothing in return as we bring our tithes, our offerings, our first fruits to him. If you have checks, make them out to Orlando Family Church. Bless the offering, and I'll turn it over to Pastor Shannon. Abba, Father, we thank you. Nothing else? We just thank you. Thank you for your goodness. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for everything that you have done for us. Thank you for another day to live. Thank you to serve you and to show your kingdom and your glory to everyone we meet. Thank you for the joy that you've given us today. Thank you that your blessings are upon us and they are overtaking us. And we have received the inheritance that your Holy Spirit has promised us. Thank you for all these good things. And for this, we just want to share a portion with you to bless you and your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.